Well, hello everyone. My name is Sandhya Swaminathan. I'm from Kunur and I did my BTech in fashion technology here in Coimbatore. Well, guess what? None of this information is important. In most occasions, we tend to judge people and see who they are before we listen to what they have to say or what message is being conveyed. So who I am, where I am from, what I wear, or what I eat, what religion or caste does not matter. We need to start listening to people and stop judging. Because I think fear of judgment is one of the major reasons why a lot of people are hesitant to express or have an opinion or even try new things. Sometimes the best message or the best creation can come from a person with no identity at all. And I believe that art is a way to express. It is a tool that can be used by anybody to express themselves. It is difficult to explain or like quantify the significance of art. You may wonder how a sketch on a tiny piece of paper is going to change the world. It cannot. It cannot bring about big changes maybe. But change need not always be at macro level. Even a small change in a single person's thinking can have a huge impact on the society. And art, I think it helps you improve your imagination and it helps you imagine how things could or should have been. It helps you think differently about everything that's happening around you. And that's a good change. To begin with my journey till today, which by the way feels surreal because never in my wildest dreams did I imagine that I'll be standing here one day giving this speech. So it's been a crazy ride. I finished college like anybody else. Started off with a decent job in a decent company, which was related to what I studied. So what more did I want, right? Most of them don't even have a job. I did. But somewhere I felt that I did not belong to that work culture, which I think most of us feel at some point, but does nothing about it. I chose to act and I quit. I decided to take that like time out and break that I needed. I did have my own commitments, like my loans and every problem everybody has. But I chose to take that risk, and it was during that time that I started sketching. So it started as a time killer, and I remember enjoying the process of creating something on my own for the first time. And that feeling is unexplainable, and I felt so happy and confident that I posted some of it on social media. And I received like really encouraging comments and appreciation from my friends and people I knew. And that made me feel even better. So I sketched even more, not for anyone else, but for myself. And slowly it turned into a passion. But it wasn't my profession yet. I thought like, if this is what I like to do, then this is what I should be doing for a living. I've read somewhere that 70% of your life is your work life. And if you don't enjoy doing what you're doing, then you're wasting almost 70% of your life. And that's crazy, and that's a sad life. So I thought I'll find ways to make a living out of what I love doing. Initially, I had no idea how or what to do about it. But then I decided I'll focus only on improving my skill, you know, and getting that perfection that I wanted. So I started doing just that. So slowly I started getting orders from people I knew and on social media, and my portrait was considered as a special gift to that special person in their life. So it had to be up to the mark. So I practiced even harder, tried different styles, and that's one thing I'd like to stress here. Practice. Practice till you perfect it. I know it sounds like a cliched statement, but it is what it is, and perfection does not come overnight. But I'll tell you, do not give up too soon. Once you start seeing that progress in whatever you're doing, you will start believing in yourself and people around you will start believing in you. And everything will fall in place. You will not have to go behind anyone or anything to build a career. It will all come to you if you are good at what you're doing. And also have an open mind, like, you know, to try new things and expand your intellect. I didn't have to go to a gallery and let someone decide if my work was nice enough to show to an audience. I posted it on social media and got immediate response, immediate comments and feedback on my work. So use your social media platforms to like establish and, you know, put out your works and talents and use it to your benefit. So that's what I did. And I received positive comments from people who I didn't even know or had no connection in real life. And that was amazing. I did receive criticisms as well. So I used some of the criticisms to my own benefit to improve my skill. And the rest, obviously, I ignored. They are meant to be ignored. Even in real life, people around me have always been encouraging me. My parents, my friends. But there are these two people who have always been with me from day one till today, and that's my brother and my best friend. So both of them believed in me and more than I did in myself, and they have been supportive from day one. So I'm thankful to all of them who have encouraged me. So use all that positive energy that's around you and use it to build yourself. Another turning point in my life is when I started conducting workshops. So here I started getting an opportunity to teach what I know, right? So I realized that more than creating art, the joy and the joy that I got from sharing that knowledge was even more. I know I've had students from 6-year-olds to 60-year-olds, and that showed me that art has no age limit. Sometimes they are the most curious ones and they are the most active students I've had. What I'm trying to spread here is not what I have achieved, what others have achieved with it. For example, if you take this 6-year-old and 10-year-old who came to my workshop, she didn't come there for me. She didn't know who I was. She came there just to sketch and nothing else. She didn't know what I was saying or what my name was, but she did what she could and she learned something that she'll never forget. She discovered that she could sketch too. Go up to her and ask her what she took that day from that workshop. It's not what I spoke, it's not my inspiration, it's not my words. It's that piece of paper with her work on it. So that's the day she discovered she could sketch. So that's the case with all my students. If they are sending me their works, it is not to please me. It is to show how much interest they've developed in art and how much art has changed their lives. Another special incident that I'd like to share with you guys is in one of my workshops, there was this girl who constantly kept asking her friend about what I was saying and she was trying to understand what I was saying. So initially I thought like maybe she had some problem with understanding the language or something that I said. So I went up to her and asked her the same, only to realize that she was actually deaf and she cannot hear anything that I said that day. But she still came there and she wanted to improve her skill. I didn't know what to say, I was speechless, I didn't know how to react. But that day I realized that how important art is to her. This can seem like a small incident, but to me it is a lesson and an encouragement to do what I'm doing. The happiness that she expressed at the end of the workshop with some noises that she made is something that drives me even today. And that's a day I'll never forget, and that's a girl I'll never forget. So I do celebrity portraits as well, people who inspire me. Any Vijay fans? Yeah? Yeah, me too. So, and anything around me that's happening that's affected me some way or the other, but there is this series of sketches that I did, which is certain tribes across the world. For example, this particular tribe. This picture is from a series called Before They Pass Away by Jimmy Nelson, who is a famous photographer. And he captures different tribes across the world, the indigenous people. And the sad thing about this is that most of them are almost on the verge of extinction. So when I sketched them, I studied their lives and I realized how art and color in their lives is so pure, raw and untouched. For example, why I chose this particular tribe is because they use art as a power and a source of identity. and that's how important it is to them. In today's world, with all the drama that's happening around us, we have forgotten where we came from, we have forgotten our origin, and the importance of art in our lives. We are all born as artists by nature, and we have evolved to be what we are right now. So, I'm here to tell you how art can impact your life. I'm a standing example of how you can use art to express yourself or explore the world and within. So I'm not telling you all to become artists just in one day. I'm just telling you, if any day you want a getaway or a break from something that you're doing, create something on your own. It does not have to be a sketch in particular. Anything that you enjoy doing. Because the feeling that you get from a paintbrush and a paint on a canvas board is something that feeds your brain. It improves your imagination, and you can use that imagination as a tool or a weapon in the war of sad realities. So make an effort and try something new. Okay, today we'll be experiencing that feeling a little bit. So I planned a sketch that we can all do together. It's a caricature. So it's just a 3-minute sketch. I think we've been given notepads and pens. So you can just take it out. We'll just do a quick sketch. So I've been telling you, experience it, do it. Caricature, a cartoon, so just have fun, okay? So let's just use that as a reference, but do not worry about, you know, getting it perfectly or even like, you know, getting that resemblance. It does not have to look like that guy. It's okay. So even I am bad at caricatures, by the way. I do more of photorealism and hyperrealism, so I am also equally bad. So I'm with you guys here, okay? So let's start. So one thing about caricatures is whatever shape you see on your reference, you have the power to exaggerate it, right? You can make it bigger, make it sharper. You can use lines instead of curves. You know, you can have rough edges, smooth edges. It's your wish. How much you exaggerate and all, nobody can teach you. It's up to you. So you can create your own art. Mine is going to be really bad, and it can be bad, like worse than some of you here. So feel confident. When you use a marker or a pen, always feel confident to use it. And that's when you feel like, you know, you can do it, right? So let's start. So what I like to do is always go from top to down, or like outer to inner. So I finish the outer outline, that is the head and the shape of the face, and then I go into the features. So it's your wish, you can start from inside as well. So I start with the forehead. So he has a flat forehead, can you see that? So we can draw a straight line, right? You don't have to worry about realism. So let me just draw a straight line. So he has like two divisions. Then his head goes in, right? And then it goes out, the cheek goes out. So I'm just drawing. And you feel his jawline going in, and then the chin. So then his hair. So let's just draw lines. You don't have to worry about, just draw shapes. Okay? And his ears, I think he has small ears, so let's just stick to a normal size, right? We'll go in the features. So his neck. So let's just get his eyebrows. Don't worry about the shape of the eyebrows and all. You know how generally eyebrows are. Just draw two curves like this, maybe with sharp ends. And do you notice his eyes being very close to the eyebrows? We'll try to get that, so at least some resemblance you'll have. So just draw the crease line first. Yeah, you have the eye? Just the upper eyelid. His eyes are a little bit shrunk, right? Do you see that? He's like kind of like closing his eyes a little bit. So let's draw the lower lid very close to the upper eyelid. Don't leave a huge gap. Don't draw a curve that goes down. And you see some shadow going out here and going out here. So let's get that. And then we'll go down to the iris and the reflection. Right? It's okay if it looks funny. Caricatures should look funny. So let's just get some shadow here. His eye bulge. Just to show where his nose starts. So if it is realistic drawing, you will not have so many lines on the face. You won't mark your nose or anything. It all comes out with shading. But in caricatures, you can actually draw it. So then the nose. He has a pretty like medium-sized nose, I guess. So just draw a curve and two curves on the side. And a little bit of shadow here. Yeah. Okay, done. We'll go into the lips. Last. So start with a V shape in the middle for the lip. And just extend it. He's smiling, so let's just have that smile line. Right? And then you have just the lower part of the lip and then the lower lip, okay? So one tip when you're drawing is like when you're drawing from one direction, don't go complete it in the same direction. Come halfway, stop. Then come the other way because your face is almost bisected, right? So it has to be the same. Right? And then so he has a little bit of shadow going on here. Yeah? And he has a dimple. Let's get that dimple. And my favorite part, the smile line. So let's do that. Okay, that's bad. And then the chin. So for the hair, just like to show the direction of the hair, just draw like strokes maybe. That's it. That's not bad. Okay. It has nothing like that, right? Thank you, thank you. But what I'm trying to tell is just experience it. If I tell, yeah, try sketching whenever you have time, I'm sure once you go home, you're not going to do it. So I just wanted you to experience it here when you have that feeling of, you know, understanding art. So I'd like to show one of my artwork. Okay. This is something very special to me. It is not my best work or it is not a masterpiece, but it is something that I did with my own perception and imagination. Thank you. So here I'm trying to say what an artist's point of view is about life. And that's exactly what I'm saying this whole time. Have your own point of view in whatever you do. People may encourage, discourage, appreciate, let you down. Some may like it, some may not. But who cares? Like, whatever you do, you should be your own critic. So go home and try something. If you did not enjoy or find that satisfaction that I'm talking about by the end of what you did, Forget everything, forget whatever I said, stop doing what you're doing and do what makes you happy, because that's what that matters. So I'd like to end by saying that if you have a knowledge, share it with others. Because you might be the smartest person alive, but if you cannot educate someone who's around you or impact someone's life, then you're doing nothing to change this world or make it a better place. You'll just sit there, complain, and die one day, and that's a sad life. That's not the purpose of our life. So if you're growing, help others around you grow as well. And that's the change we need in ourselves. Before we change the society or create a change, have a change in yourself. And that's my time, I guess. So thank you. Thank you so much.